Claudine Longet saw mountains of media attention during the 1960s and 1970s, though perhaps not the kind she would have desired. Following the murder of her boyfriend in a controversial trial, she disappeared from the limelight and into the mountains of Colorado. Here's more about the mysterious former French star. Longet was born in Paris, France in 1942 to an X-ray manufacturer and a doctor. Her own career path ended up being a little more flamboyant. At the age of 17, she began dancing at the Parisian cabaret club Folie Bergère. Subsequently, a club owner named Lou Walters saw her dancing on French TV and invited her to Las Vegas to become a showgirl. Longet met Moon River crooner Andy Williams when she was still a teenage Las Vegas showgirl. According to GQ, there have been conflicting reports about their first meeting. One involves Williams coming to Longet's rescue in a limo after her car broke down on the Las Vegas Strip, while another involves Williams claiming to remember seeing Longet roller skating near Paris Louvre Museum a decade prior. But it has been most widely reported that the pair met while Longet was dancing at the Tropicana Casino in 1960. Longet and Williams married in December 1961. Longet's guest appearances on her husband's The Andy Williams Show launched both her acting and singing careers. During an appearance on the NBC drama Run for Your Life, Longet was tasked with performing a bossa nova song called Meditation. According to Williams' 2009 memoir, Moon River and Me, her performance led to audiences flooding the NBC switchboard with calls inquiring about her. Williams told his friend Herb Alpert of the very popular brass band Herb Alpert and the Tijuana Brass about the reaction. Williams recalled in his book, "I called him and told him what had happened after the show aired. I'd like to hear that song," Herb said. "So I sent him a tape of the show. He loved Claudine's sound and immediately signed her to his label." Through Alpert's A&M Records label, Longet released 5 albums full of what Williams described as, quote, "easy listening songs in that distinctive breath and very sexy accent." Williams then invited Longet onto his own label, Barnaby, to release 2 more albums. Longet's first album, Claudine, sold over 1 million copies, and she had 4 top 100 hits. Following their 1961 marriage, Claudine Longet and Andy Williams found themselves running with a high-profile showbiz crowd that included the likes of singer Barbara Streisand, astronaut John Glenn, and Senator Robert F. Kennedy. Longet and Williams were among Kennedy's staunchest supporters during his 1968 Democratic presidential campaign, even though Williams was a Republican. The couple even had plans to meet up with the politician the night he was fatally shot on June 5, 1968. According to the Los Angeles Times, Williams sang Battle Hymn of the Republic at Kennedy's funeral, which he called, quote, "the hardest thing I ever did." Williams and Longet named their youngest son, Robert, after the late politician the following year. The couple had 3 children in the 60s, but their marriage had reportedly fallen apart by the end of the decade, and they separated shortly thereafter. Longet moved to Aspen, Colorado in the early 70s, and her divorce from Williams was finalized in 1975. Still, the two remained close friends until his death in 2012. According to GQ, their son Bobby said, "They had a great relationship. As a child, I said, 'Boy, I'm glad my parents aren't divorced.' And they were." A year after she moved to Aspen, Colorado, Longet met skiing champion Vladimir Spider Savage. They fell in love, and Longet, along with her 3 children, soon moved into Savage's luxury chalet in Starwood. What ensued was a reportedly tumultuous 4-year relationship that ended with Longet with a gun in her hand and Savage bleeding to death on the bathroom floor. On March 21, 1976, Longet fatally shot Savage with a .22 caliber pistol. The single bullet punctured Savage's side and severed a major artery. He bled out by the time help arrived on the scene, after a nearby security guard called the police. Longet claimed it was an accidental shooting that occurred while Savage was showing her how to use the gun, but she was arrested on the scene. The shooting and arrest led to a trial that local celebrity Hunter S. Thompson, who had run for mayor of Pitkin County 6 years prior, likened to Aspen, quote, "fouling its own nest," according to GQ. The press flooded to Aspen, which created what the New York Times described as, quote, "a tiny economic boom in the midst of the worst ski season in 40 years because of a lack of snow." The Savage family and the people of Aspen were left outraged after Longet was convicted of misdemeanor negligent homicide, which required her to serve just 30 days in the county jail on the dates of her choosing.
The Savage family and most of Aspen is in shock.
In the late 1970s, the Rolling Stones wrote a song about Longer for their 1978 album, Some Girls. The song, titled Claudine, focuses on the fatal shooting. The song begins by referencing how Longer was given the option to carry out her sentence at a time of her choosing, and her choice to do so over the course of several weekends. Claudine's back in jail again. She only does it at weekends. The song did not make it onto the original release of Some Girls for legal reasons. Keith Richards told Spinner, "I wished, and I think all of us did at the time, that that should have been on the original album. But there was some legal difficulties and stuff. But otherwise, she was a perfect Some Girl." The song did, however, end up on a bonus disc with the 2011 reissue of Some Girls. Mick Jagger sings on the track. Now, only Spider knows for sure, but he ain't talking about it anymore. "There's blood in the chalet and blood in the snow. Washed her hands of the whole damn show."